previously on Chilling.
Religion is a very important aspect in one's life. Mm. Because for us, we believe with God everything is possible. And without God, you are nothing.
Chilling.
My name is Drago and I'm the host of Chilling, and I'm asking you, my friend, to keep the love coming on YouTube, Facebook and Twitter. That is Chilling UBC TV.
Chilling.
Good evening and welcome back to Chilling. Now, last week I introduced you a man who has a special talent. I want to refer to him as a rare breed, a very talented man who is a teacher that teaches art, and he's well gifted. Now, as you can see, we have transformed Cake Choice into a studio, manifesting most of his work around. And as you can recognize, there's some recognizable faces like Rema Namakula, the Prince of Qatar. We have that lady over there. We have Kagame right there. We have Gashumba. I'm telling you, has too much work you can deal with. It's a full encyclopedia. And he has told me that he has covered most of this in just a solid year. So I would love to ask him more questions regarding art. So Prince,
yes, Prince.
Let me also explain to them one thing that they didn't know. We decided to challenge him a little bit. We want him to do a little sketch, you know, because we don't have much time to complete a full one. So we chose one of the most recognizable faces we have around UBC TV. This is my man Herbert. I hope he will be impressed. So Prince, do the best you can do with this guy, because he's good at criticizing and scrutinizing. He's like, who is Prince? So surprise him.
Okay.
So why did you choose to do art as a medium?
Art I found when I had a talent ever since I was young.
Mm.
My brothers used to do art, by the way. So I got inspired by
is
my
Is it a
brothers.
Family thing?
Yeah, it is.
Is it branded from your father, from your granny?
My dad didn't do fine art. Mm. But he did civil engineering.
Mm.
But my brother are the ones who have been doing art, so they inspired me a lot. Mm. And I learned so many things from my fine art from them. So I got also inspired. I said, no, wow, let me just carry it up. But of course, I had a passion in life. I wanted to be someone.
Okay.
So I had to bring it up to just add on my existence. So I started art when I was too young. I used to do those comics by then when I was in primary.
No! Yeah. For real, comics?
Yes!
Wait, why can't you stay in that genre of comics? Because comics, I believe, they are the most selling.
No, currently I don't see money in comics. But I'm earning money.
You know, you're the first one to say that. Because Marvel has talented artists. You know Marvel?
Yeah, I do.
The one that does superheroic movies and stuff.
I do.
They have artists that do for them such characters. Mm. They just imagine characters and they sketch them.
Yeah.
Okay. So would you consider drawing as a passion or a career?
Drawing
Which one stands more?
Drawing is a passion.
Okay.
It's not a career.
Okay. So you would even draw if you're not earning a shilling?
Yes. I'll be
okay. Careful. So what is the best part of doing art?
The best part of it is when I begin drawing and when I see a person has just come out, really, I feel great. I also at times I don't imagine it.
Mm.
But the most part of it, when a client really appreciates
that smile they put on their face.
That smile. You know, I at least have met someone.
Because I was asking you before, like, how do you even get time to pay attention to details? Because in most of the sketches, you see you can count every little, you know, every little set of these teeth in Rema's mouth. And the eye, you can see all the light angles. And man, how do you do it?
You know, Draco, at times, there are some things whereby you need that common sense, whereby you need to be special from other people. Because so many people are being fine art. So many people are doing fine art, but at least what is that special thing you have in you that can differentiate it from other artists? That's what you have to say.
Yeah.
So I said, I have to bring out a realistic person.
Yeah.
That's what I'm bringing in. I'm bringing into realism. My art is called realism. Mm. And there are very rare Ugandan artists who can do realism to the best aspect.
Mm.
But at least for me, I said no. I have to bring out that character whereby I'm different from other artists.
Ah. And you're really setting that magic.
And I'm setting that magic.
And you're also setting a pace for them.
Yes. Yeah.
So what do you believe is the key element for creating a good composition?
The good element is just upon knowing the elements and the principles. In fine art, we have the elements and the principles. Once you've mastered all that,
I did art in secondary, yeah, but I failed. I don't know. Art seemed to be an easy subject, but I don't know. I ended up getting average grades.
Art is very easy. Because the reason why I'm saying it's very easy, I can teach senior one kids and they're able to draw very good drawings. Imagine senior one kid. I wish I could bring in some work from senior one kids.
Because it's a subject I used to run into if I wanted to get... I thought if I wanted to get free points or free marks. Mm. But man, it needs talent because...
And let me tell
you, because what you would take 3 hours, maybe, yes, for example, sketching this. Me, I would take 10, and I would be sweating every part of my body.
It would be sweating.
Yeah. Mm. So I understand. You do art professionally.
Yeah.
Do you also crazily earn from it?
I earn from it. Definitely, I do earn from it. Mm. And everything I have, I've just bought them from fine art.
Okay.
Because now my last piece of art piece goes for 350.
So I was meant to ask you that. How do you come up with this profitable pricing structure?
The price depend on I sat down and I look at the time I invest in. Because this is much time I invest in from the drawings. I can sit for 8 hours.
Wow.
Really, I can sit for 8 hours. Then you give me just a penny. Mm. You know. So I had to set up that price. Then on top of that, once you give a client the best, he's willing to pay even a million.
Yes.
Yeah. At times I tell them I charge 300, and they said, no, your work doesn't even, it shouldn't be worth that 300. It should be 1 million and plus.
Wow.
But of course, remember, you have to target an audience whereby everyone, at least you need every person to have your art. So that's the small price I put up for someone to just get my piece.
Yeah, because drawing is another thing, and then marketing is also another.
Yeah.
And marketing is that, it's not that much easy. Mm. How have you marketed your pieces?
I've been able to market my pieces through celebs, by the way. Because after university there, I just sat down and I was like, we have so many artists in Uganda, and they don't have market. So what can I put up to just gain market? So I sat down and I said, no, I should begin with the high profile people. That was my target, because I knew if at all I have those big guys, at least I'll get connections, and with connections you are able to get market. For example, I started with Kale Kiula. That is the first portrait I did in my life. So when
who is that?
Kale Kiula.
Okay, who is
the Inspector General?
Okay. Hey, Kale Kaihura.
Yeah.
The way you pronounce him.
So I started up with that guy. Someone placed an order for it, though I don't think it reached him. So someone placed an order and I bought the piece perfectly, very well. So that's where, that was my beginning point. Then I went to Bank of Uganda. And now these pieces, I used to do them, surprisingly. Because in my life after campus, you know, it's a very hard life. You need to find a way through to just earn a living. So I had to make those surprises, and I looked for these offices. Whenever I could go to someone's office and look at my work, people would love my work, and at least I could move away with 200.
Wow.
At most. So, when I, as time went by, people who, whenever a person I could draw a person, they could connect their friends. So also friends called.
It's a chain.
So now it's a chain. It's a big chain now. Only that, after like 1 year, I may say I got a breakthrough through Bob Wine. I made a drawing for Bob Wine, and you know these musicians have got a large following. So when I made a portrait for Bob Wine, I took it there, and it was very hard for me to get him by that the first start. So when he saw it, the chance I got, when he saw it, the man loved my work. He loved it so much. He said, "No, you know what, Andrew, I'm going to add you another project. Do for my family portrait."
Yeah.
So I did a family portrait. So he said, "You know what? I'm going to make you great."
How long did it take you to know that now I'm perfect, I'm good?
I had taken 2 years into practice of portraiture. I had taken 2 years, but I had a skill. Of course, one without a skill, you can't do art and you just be fantastic.
Okay.
So I had taken 2 years practicing portraiture after university.
Okay.
So Bob Wayne said, I'm going to turn your world around. Yeah. He said, okay, let me wait and I see how you're going to turn it around. So the guy started posting my works. When he posted, he could follow it with my number.
Wow.
And you can't imagine.
That's a milestone.
That's a milestone.
Wow.
Within 1 week, I got a 1,000 calls.
What?
All pressing orders.
What?
Yes.
He's a good person.
He's a good
I've interviewed him. I went to his home. I interviewed him.
Is a good
him.
Person.
You know, we all saw that he was going to be a politician. Mm. And because he has that instinct of leadership in him.
Yeah.
But I think Bobby Wine is a topic for another day. What does, you say, what does drawing mean to you personally?
Drawing is a life for me. Because without a drawing, I don't think I can do anything perfectly. I can't do anything perfectly without a drawing. Because I've earned a lot from drawing, and I'm not any simple day living drawing at all. I'm not. Without drawing, I don't have life. That's what I may say. Yeah.
So why is most of your drawing done outside? Because most guys use computers to sketch out stuff like this. They use some softwares. Why is yours more done outside? Why do you want to relate with something tangible?
Why I chose that? People want an originality. We are into the modern world whereby modernization has taken over, computers have taken over.
Yes, because I'm going to ask again that don't you feel threatened that these old softwares are coming up and somebody can literally just sit within 30 minutes, they have as much great as this speech?
Definitely I do. And I'm worried about you. That's my big worry now. But, of course, every artist, once you are a good artist, you have a creative mind. You have to be someone who can create, who can be unique from any other person. As nowadays, I'm thinking of making my works functional. I want to introduce in light.
The what?
Light. I want to introduce in light so that they can become functional.
Yeah.
When you put it in a sitting room, it's lighting.
Mm. Yes. It illuminates.
Yeah.
What?
So, as an artist, you have to look for a way of surviving. You can't allow software.
Because you have to come up with new skills.
Yes, you have to come up with new skills. And people nowadays, they want to see new things.
Yes. But let me tell you something, Andrew. Let me tell you, as we're going to take a little break, let me tell you something. People can die to get something organic, something authentic, that they see a young man sit down and they sketch by themselves.
Yeah.
All right now, guys, we're going to take a little break. We'll return back with Andrew, who is trying to finish a portrait of Mr. Herbert right here. I hope Herbert will be impressed. So we'll return shortly.
Chilling.
Now, this photo is not even just halfway crossed, but I feel like I'm convinced, well convinced. Wow, and the way he has paid attention to all the details is amazing. But listen, 9 hours later, we shall see this photo coming into fruition. And guess what? We don't have 9 hours later. So, Mr. Andrew,
yes,
you will finish this later.
Yeah.
Let us first take a conversation. I will follow it up with the guys.
Yeah.
We shall come at your workshop and then we'll follow it up. Or you will come at the station later on. So I've seen you drawing with a smile on your face.
Yeah.
Do you always do this?
I always do that because this is me. I'm doing what I love most.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if you're not in the right mood,
I don't even dare touch a pencil. Because somewhere it's not going to come out.
Okay.
And that time will do it. So I rather do other things. Hmm.
So the format in which you do art, you say you have a special format in which you do art.
Yeah.
It's called, you say it's called what?
I'm a realistic person.
Yes.
So that's realism.
Okay.
I do realism.
No, but I mean sketching.
And
you
then,
use a...
I use the TP to get details.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about the textures and everything?
The textures, I use the TP, that's the technique I use. I use a flat stone.
Mm. Because now this frame paper is much different from the ones I know, the ones I used to use at school. Why is it so different? It has sort of a rough surface.
Yeah.
Why?
This is not an ordinary paper.
Mm.
I get my papers from Kenya. I have someone who gets from me these papers.
Mm.
When a piece is done, when I draw and I get after finishing drawing, it adds value on that piece.
Mm.
That's why we prefer this kind of papers. Unlike this. The bond type, because they have types. This is a bond, this is a textured paper. So on a bond, the work looks flat.
Mm.
And really people have got used to this. Every drawing you see, every artist has drawn on bond papers.
So here it looks too plain.
Yeah, it looks too plain.
And that is a problem you don't like.
Yeah, it doesn't add value. Now there is no value in this. I don't see any value.
But it's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
I don't even care about
artist,
your paper.
Me as an artist, I see there is no value.
Okay. Yeah.
But you as a person, you are not the person, you see this is a perfect, very wonderful work. But to me, I rather prefer a textured paper than a plain paper.
And besides, Rema has a contagious smile. So you just pass me through your simple schedule. Give me a framework. Like you wake up at 6, you say.
Yeah.
You wake up at 6 with all this energy and positivity. You get a page, you lock yourself in a room, your own room, and then you get a pen and a paper, you start sketching.
Actually, my best time to draw, it's between 6 early in the morning up to 11.
Why is it like that?
Then, in the evening, from 6 up to 7.
Is that how you are groomed?
It's not how I'm groomed. The weather is always calm, and there's a lot of sunshine, there's a lot of heat. Between when around like at 1, the weather is very unfriendly. Mm. And I need that conducive environment whereby the weather is so calm, so that there is no noise, there is no a lot of sunshine to give me that disturbances. So I need to where my concentration is 100%. That's the reason why I always prefer that time. Mm.
For this kind of work, do you like need practice every day?
I don't
just to make sure you stay perfect.
I don't need practice. Already I've already got enough perfectionism that I can.
No, because you told me when you were starting up, you used to only take 12 hours, but now you take less than that.
Yeah. For me, I've done more than 400 pieces.
Excuse me.
I've done more than 400.
400.
Yes.
Wow. But I only see a few on your Facebook.
You only see a few, but I don't post all. I have so many works. Because the past 5 years, I've been drawing. And at least I make sure every 2 weeks, I have 4 portraits I produce.
Yeah.
So you can just imagine 400 pieces, over 400 pieces I've done. Already I've got enough experience. At times even I can close my eyes and I begin speaking someone.
Get out of here.
Seriously. Because I've got that, I've really mastered some techniques. Okay. And at least some structures, like a human being, now you know there are some things that don't change. Mm. There's something that won't change.
Now, most of the work, most of your work is so manifested with famous faces.
Yeah.
Do you like ask permission for these to draw these kind of people? Because they have a huge follower, as you know. Mm-hmm. They sort of may feel like you're trying to tap into their fan base or something like that. Do you ask for their permission to draw? And once you got that permission, do they pay you in return? How does it work?
Nowadays, because I sometime back, about 4 years back, I used to make surprises to people. Because most people like surprises. So I used to...
Like that Anne can see me surprise.
Yes, like that.
There's a major one, yeah.
But nowadays, people come in and make orders. I no longer do surprises.
He no longer blows his own trumpet. You're a famous person, my friend.
So all these famous people you see, they have made orders. They have pressed orders.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
They have pressed orders. So now I deal with orders.
What is your most grateful thing you've ever gotten through this work? The most grateful thing?
The most grateful thing, I may say, I wanted, in life, I wanted to meet up the governor, to meet up that person. Because we grew up, we were being told is the Bank of Uganda is signs on the currency. You can just imagine when you are young.
It's called Mutebile.
Yeah, it's called Mutebile.
Mutebile?
Yes. So I grew up wanting to meet that person. But it came to my surprise that I made a piece for him. It was a surprise, but of course I had that in mind, I can't get this person. So I made a piece. Of course my works, they stand out, they speak for themselves. And they used to tell us, in Bank of Uganda, no one can access Bank of Uganda. So when I made that piece, I carried it. I went to Bank of Uganda. And I was given free entry. Because it was a real manifestation of the person I was going to see.
So you just went to the entrance and you're like, I want to see this man.
Yes.
They couldn't even, with no doubt, they're like, this is our boss.
Yes.
Go through.
They told me to go through.
Tell me you broke a, tell me you broke a bank on that piece. Did you get like 100 million on that?
Not that. But it was actually good money.
Okay.
I made good money.
So, Andrew, let us take just one little pause and then we return with our last part.
Okay.
We are going to return shortly. See you later. Chilling. Yes, indeed. You're still watching Chilling, the best show in the world, and this is the best station in the entire diaspora. So we are still with Andrew here. an artist. Andrew, tell me, what is your most inspiring thing when you're facing a creator's block? Do you know what they call a creator's block?
Yeah.
When you're having a low spirit of work, you feel like not working. What is your best inspiration?
My best inspiration is when I look back at my first pieces, because they are different from what I've been doing.
You've grown.
Yeah. Those pieces, I used to do them in a harsh environment.
Mm.
So when I look at the kind of environment I'm in right now and I look back, then I said, wow, why can't I keep on? Because this life is a hustle. You have to hustle. You need, right now I'm earning a living from fine art. Once I don't work, I don't eat.
Mm.
So that is my biggest inspiration. Mm. I look back what I've done before in a harsh condition, then I said, wow, I can do it better.
It's good to reap what you sow. I call it cultivating success. It's good to cultivate success. Now we shall also talk about that a little bit later, because now you have your own workshop.
Yeah.
You're now stationary. But tell me something. What is your one advice or two for a person that's trying to do exactly what you're trying to do? Just right from school and is fresh, you know, excited with the charisma of wanting to draw.
My advice is, if at all anyone who's watching out there has a talent, don't sit on it. Don't wait for people to just bring it up. Struggle hard. Give in your best. Look for the best people who are better than you. Get advices, because every person, every time, each and time again, I'm getting advices from people.
Mm.
Do this and do that. And learning is a continuous process. Every time you need to learn, we need to learn from each other.
Mm.
I didn't sit down and I wait for myself, wait for someone to bring out my talent.
Mm.
No, I had to go in. I had to put in my best. I had to put in hard work. I had to struggle to just see that I'm where.
Yeah, let us talk about that little instant struggle.
Yeah.
Like, what sort of challenges did you face?
The challenges I faced was,
because marketing has to be the biggest one.
Definitely. Marketing is a challenge.
Now, listen, you can draw.
Mm-hmm.
So what?
Yeah.
You can get a pencil and draw anything.
Yes.
But then how do you get your work outside the world to see? That was the challenge, right?
Yeah. But now that challenge has gone on disappearing, because now I have connections. I have so many people. Many people have followed me.
And your milestone came when Bobby Wine
said,
I can change your life.
Is the, I praise him so much, because he has been a breakthrough for me. Many people, all my clients, it's through that chain of Bobo Wine. Bobo Wine has got so many followers. And when he posted that work, so many people came up. People shared my works.
Mm.
And celebrities shared my works.
Mm.
Comedians shared my works. That has been my best.
Last question, who is your inspiration?
My inspiration is an artist called Grigory.
I will Google about him.
He's a Brazilian,
Grigory.
Yeah, he's a Brazilian artist. He does almost what I do.
Mm.
He has been inspired. He has inspired me so much. I admire his works. So that has been my greatest inspiration.
So is this the only type of art you can do? Or you can, because I've seen your Facebook page and there's some other different sort of art that looks like portrait of nature.
Yeah. Currently, I'm basing on portraiture. I don't have time to paint nowadays, because painting takes a lot of time. Though this takes a lot of time, but painting is more of time consuming than portraiture. And people love nature.
But you know that paint earns more, right?
Paint earns more. But nowadays people are having that concept that they need nature.
Mm.
So when I draw with my pencil, people get attached to my work.
Mm.
They get that feeling, it's natural. We are going back to the old. You know, old is gold.
Mm.
That's what I can say.
Mm.
So people are taken away by my pencil. Mm. And at times I use colored pencils. And I charge colored pencils more expensive, because it's time consuming also. But most of my clients prefer.
Oh, you even draw with colored pencils?
Yes, I always also draw with colored pencils.
I've never seen your art with colored pencils.
Yeah, only those ones I do it in. When I draw, they take.
Because they have a certain budget.
Yes.
That they require.
So other works you've seen, those are my friends' work, like nature. Those are my friends' work. I'm trying to bring them up, because I have the light following now.
Mm.
So I always, yes, I nature is someone who, when he comes, he wants nature. I can do.
Mm.
I also do it, because an artist has a variety where he cuts across anything you can do. I can say, surprisingly, even you can find me on a building painting, because an artist. So I cut across.
Yeah.
At times you find me in India designing. I design certain places.
Art has found a way of giving this young man opportunities in a way that has never found before. So you're gonna look through any camera, one of those cameras, mm-hmm. and plug it in. Where can somebody find your art pieces? Yeah. Where is your stationery? And how can somebody reach you? You can even give in your digit.
My favorite people out there, my fans, I know nowadays they have fans, my clients, everyone out there. I'm so pleased, I'm so happy. You've made me who I am. You can reach me on Facebook, Prince Andrew, Twitter, you can follow me, and then you can also get me in one day. I have my office and the Home of Art. You can reach us there, Barclays Building, first floor. My work specifically there on social media, you can also get that platform there. You can reach Ande, Prince Ande on Facebook, then Twitter, you can get Ande, Instagram, you can get Ainamani-Andrew, there you can get me.
What about Snapchat?
Snapchat?
Not yet.
Not on Snapchat.
Yeah, guess what? Ande, for all this time I've been here with you trying to work with this Hubbard guy, I give you a present.
Yeah.
So I'll return shortly with Mr. Andrew's present.
Chilling.
We are back with the last part. If you haven't watched Andrew draw or heard his story, man, you have missed a lot. But you don't have to worry. Just go on YouTube and type in Chilling UBC TV, or go on Twitter, Chilling UBC TV, and Facebook. You can see most of Andrew's work. Now, as I promised before we left, that I have a present right here in my hands, and I'm going to recite it over to the main man himself. You check it out.
Wow.
And I hope you like what is in there.
I love it so much.
Check it out.
Wow.
What's that?
Yes, this is an edible.
Okay. Wow, are you going to use it?
Definitely, I'm going to use it.
I think there is also, I believe there's something else in
Whoa.
There. An art pencil.
Wow, 5B.
We are setting you to school.
Wow.
Man, keep on drawing. Remember, the sky's the limit for
yes,
you.
Yes.
Wow.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for your time. We are calling it a wrap.
Okay.
We are calling it a wrap. Thank you very much, guys, for being with us. This has been Chilling UBC TV, the best show in the entire diaspora. And we have been at Cake Choice, found on Calvin Street. Today we didn't have a meal because, as you can see, our place is preoccupied with art. We wanted to feed off art. And I'm so satisfied with art. Thank you for being such a magnificent audience. I want to thank Henry. I want to thank Herbert. I want to thank Tony. I want to thank Tony, Calvin. These guys, they have made sure that this episode comes straight to your sitting room or wherever you're watching from. And Kwanzi Classic, my brother is from Wandegea, just opposite the UTL building. So you go and find some cool clothes, find some nice fittings, just the way as I look right now. So see you later, guys. See you next Thursday. Catch our show on YouTube. It's available. And Andy has been here with me. Take care.
Next week on Chilling.
Now, some of the people that have written about you, they say that you are a manager of the 21st century. What does that even mean? I mean, which sort of attributes is such a person supposed to
what
have?
What it means that, you know, I'm a president of the future, I'm a leader of the future. Yet I'm already 48. Eh?
My name is Drago and I'm the host of Chilling, and I'm asking you, my friend, to keep the love coming on YouTube, Facebook and Twitter. That is Chilling UBC TV.